Hello everyone, myself Namrata Thakur, senior lecturer in the Department of Computer Engineering at Praveen Patil Polytechnic, Bhayandar East. Welcome to the second part, second video of the first chapter, Overview of an Operating System. I have already posted the first video, kindly go through it for revising your concept regarding OS. So let's start with the second part, a second video. From this video, the student will able to understand the different types of OS along with his example, advantages and disadvantages concluded by the differentiate between the different types of OS, if any. So, what are the different types of OS? We have already seen the concept called as an example of OS in the first video of the same chapter. I have written over there the different, or you may know these things very well, that the different examples are Windows XP, Windows 2000, Windows 10, Ubuntu, Linux, Unix, Android and many more. But the concept types of OS is completely different than example of OS. According to the operation and the function performed by the OS, we have some different types of OS as follows. The different types of OS are multi-programming OS, time-shared OS, multiprocessor system, distributed system, real-time system, and mobile OS. Let's see every operating type of operating system one by one in detail. Real-time operating system. The first type is real-time operating system. It also known as a RTOS, or Real Time Operating System. As the name suggests, Real Time Operating System, time is there, therefore it based on the time. Based on time means what? Whenever the execution of all the tasks in the system get done in a time, that concept is Real Time System. That means it is used to perform all the operation within the time. So, you must have a question in your mind, where should one can apply the real-time operating system concept? Let me give you one example so that it will more clear to you what exactly the real-time operating system is. Take the example of your home appliance washing machine. I think almost all have seen the home appliance washing machine. In that, we are putting clothes inside the washing machine. We will turn on the power. After that, washing machine will take some minutes to process it. And after that minutes get over, the machine will stop. That means everything is done within the time period given to it. Well, what will happen if execution is not done within the time period? If not done, then the system will fail. And response time is always measured in a second or millisecond. Therefore, RTOS is always used in the environment where the large number of events take place, or the large number of events are processed within the time period. See the different examples of RTOS, so it will give you the clear image of RTOS. Traffic control system, nuclear power plant, satellite communication system, live video streaming, robotics, home appliance and stock exchange system. We have already discussed what exactly home appliance system over there. Now we will see traffic control system and nuclear power plant. So again, it will be more clear to you, RTOS exactly stands where. In traffic control system, if you are not following the signal within the time, then accident will happen. In nuclear power plant, if processes are not get done within the time period, the nuclear plant will get blast. Same for the satellite communication system and the stock exchange system. If execution of the processes are not get done within the time period, it will stop the system or it will affect the system. What are the different types of RTOS? There are two different types of RTOS. First one is hard RTOS and second one is a soft RTOS. Let's see what do you mean by hard RTOS and what do you mean by soft RTOS. Hard RTOS, as the name suggests, hard RTOS. Hard means if in the system execution is not done within the time period. Execution means whatever the processes are running inside your computer system, that processes should get executed within the time. If time period exceed, then it will completely stop the system. That means it will imply the system failure. For example, hospital management and nuclear power plant. Consider or imagine if in hospital the oxygen is not given within the time period, what will happen? But obvious, it will lead to the death of the patient. In nuclear power plant, as I discussed before, if processes are not get done within the time period, then it will blast the system. That means here the late response is incorrect and it implies the complete failure of the system. The second type is soft RTOS. It is completely opposite of the hard RTOS. That means here also you have to execute all the tasks within the time period. But if the tasks are not executed or not get done within the time period, then it will affect the system, but it won't completely stop the system. It will not completely stop the system. For example, live video streaming. Student, you must have watched some video where the actor or actress are speaking something. The lip movements are there, but you are getting voice after some seconds or after some minute. That means what? The voice and the lip movement synchronization is not done within the time period. Here, the system is affected because of the time period over, but it won't stop it completely. That is the soft RTOS. Advantages and disadvantages of real-time operating system. The first advantage of real-time operating system is it will optimize the use of system resources, as every process or every task within the system has to execute within the time period. Therefore, whatever the resources we are using, that will get utilized completely. Second one, it will be best for the real-time application. This concept we can use in a real-time application. It improves the system performance as everything gets done within the time. Along with the advantages, we have a disadvantage too. As every coin has two sides, therefore, the disadvantage of real-time operating system, for the execution within the time period or for the quick response, you need a good degree of hardware over there. If you need a good degree of hardware, but obvious the cost will get increases. Therefore, the real-time operating system is very expensive and very complex too. Complex in the sense, consider the example of satellite communication system. So, is satellite communication system is easy to maintain or it is very easy? But obvious no. It is the structure of the satellite system is very complex and sometimes it is difficult to maintain. Now, we will see the next type of operating system, that is multi-programming OS. Multi-programming. It is the important feature of an OS. Whenever your OS is executing multiple program at the same time. Multiple means more than one. So whenever multiple programs are executed simultaneously, at that time that OS implies the concept called as a multi-programming. Let me give you one example. In your OS, in your laptop, you are using browser. That means you are opening the browser, you are opening the Microsoft PowerPoint, You are opening the pane, you are opening the VB.NET, at the same time you are using the media player. That means at the same time your system is executing 5 programs, that is multiple program at the same time, and you are still getting the output. That means your system implies the concept of multi-programming. But what is the use of multi-programming? But obvious, to increase the CPU utilization. CPU gets utilized whenever the CPU has a different program to execute. So in multi-programming, here as shown in the figure, the multiple programs are executed over here. And CPU has every time one job on one program to execute. In multi-programming system, when one program is waiting for performing the input-output transfer, there is another program ready to utilize the CPU. What are the advantages and disadvantages of multi-programming system? In case of multi-programming, the advantages are high and efficient CPU utilization. As I discussed before, there are n number of programs are running simultaneously. Therefore, CPU has always one program to execute and it will increase the CPU utilization. Here, the system throughput also get increases. And the user feels that many programs are allocated CPU almost simultaneously. What are the disadvantages of real-time operating system? If we are executing, means system is executing multiple programs. So the arrangement of multiple programs should be there. Therefore, the CPU scheduling is required. In multi-programming, multiple programs are get loaded in a memory for the execution. Therefore, the system should properly allocated and deallocate the program. Therefore, memory management is required and maintenance is expensive as multiple programs are running simultaneously in your system. The next question or the next topic is, what is the difference between multi-programming and multitasking? Let me tell you, what do you mean by multitasking? As the name suggests again, multitasking is multiple task execution. Whenever your system is executing multiple tasks at the same time, it is multitasking concept. For example, you are driving a car. At the same time, you are listening to music and at the same time, you are navigating something on the mobile phone. That is nothing but the multitasking. Or in case of computer, if you are browsing some information, you are searching some information, at the same time you are downloading something. That is, in one program you are implying the multiple tasks. That means in foreground there is one job executed, at the background one job again executed. This concept is called as a multitasking. So we will see the multi-programming and multitasking difference one by one. The first difference is but obvious, related to the definition. Multi-programming is multiple programs simultaneously executed. In case of multitasking, it is the execution of multiple tasks. Multi-programming always implies the multitasking, but multitasking does not imply the multi-programming. That means in case of multi-programming, along with the multiple program, you can execute the multiple task. But in case of multitasking, you can't say that it will imply the multi-programming. In multi-programming, user can't interact with the system. In multitasking, user can interact with the system. High CPU utilization and IO utilization is a multi-programming aim. In case of multitasking, it will utilize the CPU efficiently. In multi-programming, there is simple one program or multiple program. But in case of multitasking, there is one job at the foreground and one job at the background. So, thank you. Keep posting your doubts, if any. Thanks a lot.